Howdy everyone! Today we are integrating Appsmith, the leading open source low-code platform for internal tools, with Okta using SAML Single Sign-On to provide secure, streamlined access for your organization's users to Appsmith's powerful apps and dashboards. Let's talk prerequisites because we have a couple of them. First, you'll need an Appsmith Enterprise instance with an SSL certificate on, and two, an Okta admin account with the ability to create applications in your organization. With that, we'll be able to achieve today's goal. Let's dive in and see how it's done. All right, here we are in the Okta dashboard, but before we do anything here, let's go back to Appsmith and there find the settings sections. Now on the left menu, you will see the authentication area where we'll list all of the different protocols and authentication methods you can enable in Appsmith. Enable the SAML 2.0 section, and there you will see two different very important values, the redirect URL and the entity ID value. Those two we're going to need back into Okta to integrate with Appsmith. So I stay on this page and then go back to Okta. On the application sections, you will see a list of your applications, and there is the browse app catalog button. Click over there and there you will see the create new app button. Also click over there and select SAML 2.0 because remember that's the app protocol we are using. So click on next and then you will enter some basic information about this application. First, let's give it a name. I'm going to call it Appsmith, and you can optionally upload a logo. I'm going to upload a logo myself because I want it to look good. There you go. But this is optional, okay? So click on next. And now you will enter the information we were talking about, the single sign-on URL and the audience UD, which is the entity ID. So let's go back to Appsmith, click on the redirect URL value, put it here on the single sign-on URL, and then on the entity ID, also copy the entity ID value and put it over there. Then we have to just identify what the name ID format is gonna be. Click on the dropdown and select the email address and also what the application username is going to be that we're going to be integrating between Appsmith and Okta. I'm going to select also the email address because this is the way we're going to be authenticating or keeping users in sync between Okta and Appsmith, is via the email address. That's the way it's supposed to work with Appsmith. Anything else except from these values, you shouldn't be touching, but you can configure it the way you need, like adding group attributes and statements and things like that. But again, this is what we need to barely keep this integration as simple as possible. All right, so Okta is going to be setting up this integration for us. It's going to be validating that everything is as expected. And now we're going to be entering some basic information about our application, but we don't really need to enter this. It's optional from Okta. So let's click on finish. And there you will see a very important value, which is the metadata URL. That's the value we're going to be copying and entering in Appsmith so Appsmith can identify what the integration is going to be. So let's copy that. But before we go into Appsmith, we have to go to the assignments area, because we have to tell this application which users and groups are going to be able to authenticate via this SAML single sign-on we are creating. So let's assign some people. Now, again, depending on your organization, you might define which users and groups are going to be having access to this specific integration. For me, I'm just going to assign a couple of users that I have for testing. So I'm going to be assigning these two. One is a sales representative and the other one is a field production guy. And also I can do the same with some groups. I'm going to assign people that belongs to the marketing group and also to the sales group. And that's it. So with that done, we have people assigned. We have the application configured. So we can go back again and copy the metadata URL. Go to Appsmith and scroll down where it says metadata URL. We're going to be pasting that over there. And then you can put whatever name you wish to this specific integration. I'm just going to leave it as Okta Single Sign-On. And click Save and Restart. So what's going to happen here is that Appsmith is going to be registering our SAML Single Sign-On configuration. And it has to restart the server to install that information. It's going to take about 5 to 10 minutes at much, so don't be scared if that process takes a little bit depending on where you are hosting your Appsmith instance. So again, don't be scared. And as soon as this is done, we're going to be able to test out the configured SAML single sign-on that we just did. So the server restart just finished and now we're ready to test this out. So I'm gonna open a new incognito window here tab where I'm going to be using the OKTA SAML Single Sign-On option now that appears on the login form. Because now that we have enabled it, you can now use that as an authentication method. So let's click on that button. And now it's going to redirect us to the OKTA login page. So I'm gonna enter my username, which is the email test that we created or that I created and entered into my OKTA assigned users that have the ability to log into this application. I'm gonna click next here. And I have to authenticate. Let me get a push notification here to this mobile app that I have. I'm gonna tell yes, that's me. And now the authentication is gonna happen. And there you go. Just enter my credentials with OKTA. And now I'm logging into Appsmith and have my own workspace. Here's my test user account. As you can see, I'm authenticated with that specific email address that we use via OKTA Single Sign-On. So that means we completed our full integration from creating an app in OKTA, configuring SAML Single Sign-On in Appsmith, and integrating them both using the SAML 2.0 Single Sign-On with the identity manager that we just configured. So there you go. Now that you have seen how easy it's to integrate Appsmith with OKTA, start your free trial of Appsmith Enterprise today and experience the power of secure, customizable dashboards. So click on the link in the description to get started. I recommend you to watch next how to set up SCIM, which stands for System for Cross-Domain Identity Management. So you can bring all of your OKTA users, roles, and groups to Appsmith and keep them in sync. Subscribe and see you on the next one. Bye-bye.